How to Meet a Friendly Alien, Part 5, Activating Your Acceleration Portals. This message has been brought to you on behalf of the Intergalactic Brotherhood and Sisterhood of Light, channeled by Canadian psychic medium Tracy Mill. Greetings, dear ones. I am Aurelia, speaking to you on behalf of the Intergalactic Brotherhood and Sisterhood of Light. The time for our grand reunion draws ever closer, and soon your world will change forever. Undeniable proof that you are, in fact, a member of a galactic family who has been quarantined by your own negativity towards yourself and each other. You are entering a highly charged time when the energies from the central sun, designed to infuse you with inspiration, will be met by the energies of opposing forces designed to confuse you with chaos. The experiences you will be offered over the next few months will require many of you to be able to change your mind and course of action or approach in order to reach determined goals. This can lead to feelings of disappointment. And we come forward at this time to offer you a new way to look at your disappointment, a way that offers acceleration through these troubled times. Each and every one of you have a number of attributes that combine to make up the uniqueness of your personality, perspective, and life experience, whether you break it down from an astrological perspective or another point of view. Almost any list that will show your strengths will most surely mention your weaknesses as well. But where do you place your focus, dear ones? That is the question we come with today. From our perspective, we have noticed that humans tend to enjoy labels. You like the labels that you find bring out or mention your admirable qualities, like kindness or patience, humbleness or playfulness. But you tend to ignore or refuse to acknowledge some of the not-so-stellar qualities, like aggression, argumentativeness, or stubbornness. Dear ones, these are just words, and they hold no power over you until you give them power over you. For it is what you believe those words represent that vibrationally can work for you or against you. For example, being stubborn can be helpful when there is a project that needs follow-through and a job to get done. Being argumentative can put a stop to an injustice from happening or help to defend someone in need of some courage or clarity. However, if you disavow these parts of yourself as even existing and then judge yourself when they do pop up, how on earth are you ever going to break this cycle of self-judgment and then judging everyone else as well? For make no mistake, dear heart, that is what you are here to do. You are here to change a vibration that is carried by the majority of people on planet Earth, one heart at a time. Pretending that you don't have a shadow side is an illusion that can leave you reacting from your weaknesses instead of acting from your strengths. Most people are simply trying to do the best they can with what they've got to work with, and everyone on Earth has felt disappointed at some time in their life or other. It's what you do with your disappointment that will determine what level of authenticity you will play from. Whether you like it or not, you influence each other, and the best that you can do as spiritually evolving beings is to choose to bring forward your best attributes in the hopes that those you play with will do the same. But there is never a guarantee. As far as we can tell, the only way to keep from bumping into personalities is to hide in a cave, and that is not what you came here to do, dear one. You came here to mix it up with each other. You came here choosing attributes that you knew would come naturally to you based on the astrology at play on the time and date of your birth. When you planned your life mission, you chose your challenges and your challengers to help you to get to those aha moments that you came here to get. So those people who bring out the worst in you might be bringing you your biggest lessons. Don't hate them, dear one. Thank them instead. At the end of the day, who you will be and what aspects of your character you will reflect to others is your choice and nobody else's. You choose what level of character and authenticity you will play from. You choose whether to act from a wounded ego, which usually reaps lousy results, or to play from your highest self, which often reaps hidden lessons, insights, and many blessings. For true freedom lies in honoring and owning your nice qualities and your not-so-nice ones. True freedom comes from releasing self-judgment and self-denial that has kept both you and your beautiful planet under lock and key. As you know, pretending something doesn't exist is a surefire way to keep it in place longer. So stand up to those challenges. Learn those lessons. Remember, labels are just labels. They only become meaningful when you do something meaningful with them. True freedom lies in a willingness to be yourself and to play from your best, most authentic self, to learn the lessons you came here to learn, to enrich the world where you see fit, and then to go home. It's your world. Earth is a free will zone. So be kind to each other and lose the labels. They're not helping anybody. In love always, the Intergalactic Brotherhood and Sisterhood of Light. Namaste. This has been a message from the Intergalactic Brotherhood and Sisterhood of Light, brought to you by WhatComesNextForYou.com.